Welcome back to The Witcher 3. Let's continue following the Lubberkin and hopefully end this quest once and for all so I can stop thinking about all of the horrible things that just happened. Oh god, please end. I don't know, I got a feeling there's quite a bit left in this quest. Nope. Nope. Ain't gonna fight you. Nor any of your wolfkin.
A fisherman's hut. Seems she wants me to take a closer look.
Oh, there's someone here.
Who's that? At the room. Go on now.
What you seek here, sir? Our hut's out of the way. Woeful. We has nothing. We knows nothing.
Just need information. Looking for two women, the Bloody Baron's wife and daughter.
Not a soul have been here, sir.
Sure? Not even passing through? Daughter's medium height, about 20. Her mother's thin, about 40. Seen them?
That sir came at night, right, Mummy? Quiet, boy!
Well, that just gave it away.
Where'd the girl go? Your son said enough, no point in playing dumb anymore.
Sorry, sir, but you don't look like one of her father's men.
Because I'm not. I'm looking for Tamara and her mother. I need to know if they're alive and safe.
Tamara is, aye. She's to my brother's place in Oxenford. But Mrs. Anna, that's another tale. Though anywhere's better than the crow's perch with a baron.
Why?
Cause he beat her, sir. Beat Mrs. Anna, I means. Everyone knew, but not a one lifted a finger for to stop it.
What happened to Tamara's mother?
T'were like this. I was awaiting in the old smokehouse with horses. Cold as hell and so dark, couldn't see past two elves in front of ye. Moon had arisen high, and still they hadn't come. Began to fear some demon had snatched them. But finally, they came forth, and we sets off towards the river. Suddenly, out of nowhere, a gale arose. Thought it'd tear my head off. And those damn birds, swarms of them coursing o'er the woods, raising the racket to make your ears bleed. Mrs. Anna screamed, bent over into herself. Tamara knelt down, gripped her arms. 'Twas then I saw it. Fiery marks on her hands.
What marks?
These... well, like burned on with hot iron on the palms inside.
Burned? Like a cattle brand?
Aye, though these wasn't black scars scabbed over. These hot and glowing, as if they burned with raw fire.
What the heck would cause something like that?
Why help them at all? You risked a lot.
I did that. Old Miss Tamara. 3 moons passed, a fever gripped my boy. We thought he was done for. Tamara alerted, brought food and salves. We're poorer than dirt itself. She saved my boy. No two ways about it. Me, myself, I'd have never dared to help. But my missus told me, a time of war and contempt's come, a time of folk gone wrong. We needs to repay good with good. Who stands by idly does evil as if.
Married a wise woman.
Crying shame we couldn't save Mrs. Anna in the end.
She died?
Fine. What happened next?
Grew even darker. Seemed someone had put out the stars. Crickets all went silent of a sudden. And then, from the woods, a roar. broke out in a cold sweat, and before I could catch my breath, a beast jumped out of the woods, big as a barn, with horns and two burning coals for eyes. I thought I was done for. Beast attacked Mrs. Anna's horse, ripped its head off, carried her off into the woods. Our horses, mine and Miss Tamara's, got spooked and tore off willy-nilly. T'was the only reason we escaped. The miss wanted to go back for her mother, but my wife pleaded, said she'd die out there alone. Miss Tamara agreed not to go.
You know, that tale sounds almost ridiculous, but, I mean, given what I've seen, given what I've seen with the horse, being clawed up and with its head torn off, it seems he's telling the truth. It just sounds so fantastical, doesn't it? Repaying a debt and then, for some reason, the mother has marks appear on her as if, like, branded with raw fire, and then the birds go crazy and everything turns black and misty or whatever, and this demon creature with horns comes out of the woods. It sounds ridiculous, but the evidence is there, and, well, stranger creatures exist.
Thanks for your help.
The lady, she'll be all right in the end, won't she?
I'll do what I can to see that she is. So here our paths diverge. Thank you, Dea. Go in peace.
I wonder where Dea's going. Where do Lubberkins go when they're not needed? Alright, looks like we need to go back to the Baron. Mm-hmm. Hold on, there's no, are there any question marks along the way we can hit up? Nope. I just pissed something off. Was it the wolves again? Probably the wolves. Have fun finding the drowners, folks. Oh, the drowners stopped coming. I thought the guards were gonna have to fight him. You know, I really need to repair my equipment. I should probably do that. Hold on. More notices on the notice board. No new quests? Nothing? Tis a shame.
Remember me?
Nope.
Stable Hand pulled you out of the fire.
We'll never forget that. Here. I'm grateful.
Went to the village for the levy. And that one hard banged a lass. So the bloody Baron ripped him a new one.
I feel bad for not noticing, or not remembering his face, but I never actually got to see his face in the first place.
Witcher, a word, please.
This person looks dangerous. Look at those, like, sunken eyes.
What is it?
That night, when the Baron ordered everyone to lock their doors, stay inside. What did you and the Baron do?
Gotta ask the Baron about that. Speaking of which, know where he is?
Garden. Spends a lot of time sitting there of late.
Drunk?
No. Don't drink, don't eat. Just sit.
Not just now.
Maybe he's actually realized what he's done. Maybe he can actually change. I can only hope.
There you are.
See the hollyhock there? The violet blooms. Brought the plants here from Nazaire. Anna had read some story. Insisted on having them. Spent hours tending to them, trimming, pruning. She was so content at that. And them, the frilly ones, called birds of paradise in Zerikania. But Tamara called them dragons of paradise. She adored them. Damn shame I'll never learn which blooms would please Dea most. Though it's good to know her spirit's free.
Got some information about your family.
You've learned something? Well, let's go inside. It's a bit chilly out. Any news for me?
Your daughter's in Oxenfurt.
What the blazes? She all right? In good health? Safe? Why haven't you brought her back?
Never offered to do that.
How do you know she's safe? You see her at least?
No, but I talked to the man who helped her escape and then took her in. Tamara is safe and sound. From what I gathered, she has no desire to see you again, no intention to return.
I shan't trust some peasant dolt. I shan't trust whoever it has helped her. I need to know for certain she's safe. Go to her. You must be sure. See her yourself. I shan't believe anyone else.
Is there any harm in telling him that she's safe, in going and actually checking on her? I would like to know for sure. On the other hand, you know, I hadn't even thought about it before, but yeah, trying to find his family, I don't want to bring his family back to him. He doesn't deserve his family. And his family doesn't deserve the abuse of him. Has he changed his ways now? Maybe, who knows, I don't care. Don't give a damn. Everything in the past shows he's been abusive. I'm not going to assume or hope that he's changed his ways. So, fuck that. So I'm kind of worried that if I do go check on her, maybe he'll track me and find her that way or something. But I do want to see her for myself. I do want to know. I mean, the Baron said he never hit Tamara, right? Never hit the kid? It's okay, I can return her then, right? He only ever hit her mother. Everything's fine. That was sarcasm, by the way. No, I'm not bringing Tamara. Or the mother back. Alright, I'll go. I want to see Tamara.
That much I can do.
I'm grateful. Take this, call it enticement, and this might prove useful.
What is it?
A letter of safe conduct. Ever since the Redanians took hold of the Pontar Delta, they made it damned hard to get to Novigrad without one. Very well. You were to find them both. What of Anna? Learned anything?
Nothing yet, but I'm on her trail.
Well, what are you waiting for?
For you to tell me about Ciri, like we agreed.
Fine. A word once given. When Ciri was on the mend, we took her out on a hunt. Thought a bit of galloping would warm up her limbs gone stiff from so much bed rest.
Ooh, do I get to play as Ciri again? Please tell me I do, I want to teleport. Let me teleport.
That lass of yours. Pure luck in the flesh. To hunt down a wild boar that size. Why, worthy of one of King Foltest's feasts, were he still among the living. Ciri, come! Our haunt should be yours as I see it.
Oh, you're doing well, lass.
Not bad. Not bad at all. But who goes boar hunting with a sword?
No bow at hand, no spear. My sword was all I had.
Well, you brandished it beautifully. Where'd they teach you that, anyway?
You know what I'm really surprised about? Is that the Baron and all these guys so far seem to be treating her just like another person. Which is good, but... You know, I'm so used to fantasy things when you have a woman character with a sword. It's always the guy's like, oh, you really know how to use that, you know, blah, 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 sexist, sexist, blah, blah, blah. Like, I'm actually really surprised, pleasantly surprised. Alright, where'd they teach you that? Should I be specific? Yeah, sure, why not? I don't think Kaer Morhen's a secret, is it?
At Kaer Morhen?
Witcher school there, aye? But they only took lads, as I recall.
For some reason, Ciri keeps, like, moving every, like, 5 or 10 seconds. Like, her animation goes all weird. Is she not a Witcher? I thought she was a Witcher. Is she not a Witcher? I'm pretty sure she is, so I guess saying I'm not a Witcher would be a lie, I think.
They made an exception for me.
Right. Mean to say you're a she-Witcher?
Not entirely. The mutations, I was never subjected to them. But everything else I know, I learned from the witches there.
Know any of them potions?
Not so much. A bit.
Because you see, at times I get this pinching back here.
Shut it, Ygrin. Nobody cares about your backside. A woman could swing a sword, I've knowed one, but never seen a lady mount anything but a cock proper.
Okay, there we go. Never mind.
Horseback. Nothing strange on account they bloody mount them sideways.
Perhaps you'd Kaer to wager?
Think you can outrun me on an horse? Naturally. What's the stake?
Black mare. The one in the stable.
Oh, that won't do at all.
Well, they avoided the sexist fantasy tropes for about 2 minutes. I was pleasantly surprised for a little bit.
Well, that's an awfully gloomy face. Too much of a coward to race a woman.
The horse is mine.
To race the Baron himself, I'd consider it an honor.
Oh, that'd be a sight to behold.
Would it ever?
Done. But if I win, I take your sword.
Agreed.
But not drink any more this night. You'll want your head about you. And we start at daybreak.
I hope I get to actually race. Come on, race. Kaniner.
The day dawns.
Ready?
As ever. First one to the tower.
Man chop!
Alright, here we go. Forget the GPS, just follow the trail, I think. See ya! Once again, stamina management is probably important, so I'm gonna take the stamina down to maybe halfway. Alright. Normal sprint. No, stop. Sprinting. There we go. Try to block off the Baron. There we go. Just trying to block him off. And let's start sprinting again.
You're wind, not woman. Worthy of the best horse. The mare is yours.
Thank you.
What?
Another chance to win.
Do I have to actually fight that thing now?
She screamed like a mad woman. In an instant, all had forgotten the wager. Every man ran to save his skin, even were it to break his neck.
And they make it?
Some, aye. Others were not so fortunate. But what happened then? I must say, Witcher, seen a lot, but nothing like this. Never.
Uh-oh. I know that look.
You're a fast learner. You'll know the rest once you find my wife.
Working on it.
And making piss-poor progress.
They split up. Hadn't considered that possibility before. But don't worry. I'll find Anna, too. So long.
Pam, pam, param. Pam, param.
What? Pam, pam, param? What? Okay, I messed up the recording. I don't exactly know what happened. Anyway, some stuff happened. I honestly don't remember exactly what it was. I cut Geralt's hair and beard. Now he looks super sexy. Did a couple side quests. Whatever. Let's just keep going. So I came back here to finally tackle Jenny of the Woods. Because I think I'm able to now. I'm a little bit higher level. I think two higher levels. And I have the proper bomb. And oil. So let's do this. Yeah, so moon dust prevents monsters from transforming, which is very important because when she transforms and spawns all those little, like, mimics of her, that's when she heals. And she heals really, really fast. So let's put that on. And she is cursed, right? Wait, is she a specter or cursed? Hold on. Let's check. Specter. Okay. So Yurden, specter oil, moon dust. See, I've got all the things she's vulnerable against. I have, thankfully. Don't hold it down. Alright, so Moondust. Quen. Gonna have to Yurden. Okay, and I've heard that if you fight her during the day, she's actually a lot weaker. So I should fight her during the day if I want her to be at her weakest, but I kinda wanna try just fighting her here. Let's see if this says anything about it. She herself can take on an immaterial form, rendering her invulnerable to blows. The best way to force her out of this state is to set a trap with the Yurden sign, then quickly follow up with Igni while she is caught. Never attempt to fight one in the middle of the night when the moon hangs high in the sky. Okay, you know what? If the bestiary entry says never, then let's take that seriously. Alright, let's try this now. Oh, it looks like, yeah, it's actually still got the oil on it. Oh, the oil doesn't disappear with time, it disappears with use. It says 20 out of 20. Cool. Let's do this. Come on, Jenny. Yeah, without Yurden, that does, like, nothing. Come on. Oh man, even during daylight, she's still hard. I need a swallow. Oh, I forgot to Thunderbolt too. Oh crap. No, that's what I should have stopped her. She's gonna heal. Oh, no, actually, no, she's not. Alright, here we go. Lots of damage right now. No, you don't. You're not healing, are you? Where'd you go? No, she's healing! Okay, not too bad, not too bad. She's still taking a lot of damage. I am poisoned right now. Alright, almost got her. She's not healing, is she? Oh, damn, she is. Alright, come on. Wait, no, she's not healing. I thought more appeared of her. Oh, that was a tough fight. That's a lot of things to manage, Jesus. Swallow and Thunderbolt and then Quen and then Yirden. Whew. And I don't get the bombs, the moon dust bombs. I didn't feel like they did anything. She dropped a sword. Hopefully that's a steel sword, because I've got enough silver ones. Let's go rest for a minute. Get our stuff back. Alright, let's check out that new weapon. It is a steel sword! Okay, it does a little bit less damage than the one I have right now, but not much. And it's got a base 10% chance to stun. That's really good. Plus it's got 3 rune slots. Oh yeah, that's better. It's all like, it's got that, like, serrated, like, flame burge style blade. I think it's called flame burge. Yeah, it's only level 3, but it's still pretty good. Let's, shove some runes in it. Also, let's check out the new trophy. 5% bonus experience from humans and non-humans. Alright, that's pretty basic. I've got 2 other heads that, that do the same thing. 2% chance to freeze. Chance to poison. I like making it a stunning weapon. That sounds nice. 5% chance to stun. That's really good. Yeah, it's a greater runestone. The thing is, though, I don't want to use great runestones on this thing, because it's not that great. Like, it's better than what I have, but it's only level 3. Yeah, I don't want to use my greatest stuff. I want to save that. So let's use some of the lesser ones. Armor piercing, that's always good, especially for a sword that's meant to be used on humans, which often have armor. Let's add in a chance to freeze. and a chance to stun. Yeah, so 12% chance to stun, and 2% chance to freeze. Cool. I'm happy with that. Some enemies over here. For a second I thought there was something in the sky because I swore I heard like wings, but... just a bunch of wolves. Whatever. I'm tired of fighting wolves.
Greetings.
What do ye want?
Jenny of the Woods is gone. Got rid of her.
She'll not be back.
No. I know how to dispatch night wraiths for good.
Aye, of course. Your reward, as agreed. Many thanks to ye, Master Witcher.
Farewell.
Hair white as curd.
Come on.
Come on, Roach. Come on.
My man went to see the witch again.
Okay, what adventure do I want to get off to now? Still avoiding the main quest for the most part. Let's go check out some of these question marks. Let's go for that one.
Come on, Roach.
Hello, excuse me.
See, you're a man well traveled, so tell me.
I think that guy was trying to strike up a conversation with the wind left behind in my wake. What do we got here? Banditos. That's a silver sword. There we go. Let's use our new stunny, poisony sword. Well, actually, it doesn't poison. But it does stun. Let's use some Hanged Man's Venom. Also, let's replace out the Moondust with Dragon's Dream. Yeah, let's go ahead and use Dragon's Dream appropriately this time. By exploding it.
He can't take this!
Oh yeah! Ow. Ow. Holy shit. They have a lot of bows. Jesus. A lot of bows.
Bid life farewell.
All together now. How, damn it.
All right, they're in a huge group, so I'm just going to poison them. They're so stupid staying together in a group like that, oh my god. They're all just getting poisoned to death. Alright, wow, I just took out like five of them. Dang.
Nighty-night.
Oh, you're the one going to sleep. Oh no, you don't. Oh, maybe you do. Oh my god, he killed his own person. I stunned him.
No.
This sword is really good, it keeps stunning.
Form a row.
Come on, come at me. Let me test my parry skills. Look, I already stunned him. Again! Wow. This sword is really good. It's really, really good. Yep, yeah, welcome back. Everybody's happy. Mm-hmm. Whoops.
Where'd you come from?
Actually, I should probably read that. What does that say? The fire cleanses. Brothers and sisters, join us at Devil's Leap.
Answer my prayer.
Is that the Church of the Eternal Fire? I wonder where Devil's Leap is. Look, they're just parked around the campfire with this dead, bloody body right behind them. Like, they really don't care. Look, there's kids playing around here.
You can try to win them all, but you won't.
Oh. You know, Witcher, folk can say what they will. Me, I'll never forget what you did for us.
Oh, thank you, sir. That guy knows that witchers aren't bad. His legs are literally touching a dead body.
Never eaten tree bark? Me, I got splinters coming out my arse from it.
Why did you eat tree bark? Weirdo.
Not looking good, I tell you.
Next. Heading back to the wrecked ships on the coast. Should probably rest for a little bit too. Let's wait until daylight. Drownies. What are drowners again? What category of oil? Necrophage. Draw them into the cloud. Good enough. Is there anything else around this rock? Perhaps behind? Oh, wait, this isn't a rock, this is a freaking whale. Ew. Ew, ew, ew. Yeah, I thought this was a rock. I really didn't look very closely at it. I wonder if I can take on the guarded treasure now. It's another wraith, right? Let's go see. think I've gained a couple levels since I looked at this thing, so I might be able to take it now. Some sort of a wraith, I believe. I think it's a night wraith. Noon wraith. Level 15? Well, let's put the right oil on. We'll see. I barely made a mark on that thing. Nope. Nope, level 15 is way too high. Let's start checking out these question marks. There's probably some more treasure under the sea, I think. I'm kind of working my way towards the Kira Metz thing. Slowly. Oh yeah, somebody told me that you can actually use your crossbow underwater. Although, right now I can't actually take out my crossbow, so I guess I need to get on land to do that first. Let's do that. Let's take out my crossbow and put on Quinn. Also, there's gotta be something on this long strip of land. Ooh. Enhanced hybrid oil. I didn't know you can make enhanced oil.
I'm too old for treks that long.
Nope. Yes, I know. Thank you. Let's actually go ahead and check out that alchemy formula. I want to know if I can make it. The enhanced one. What do I need? Urania Eye. Plus 25% attack power versus hybrids. That's very good. Yeah, I'm guessing this eye is maybe hard to get. I thought there'd be drowners around here, but I don't see any on the minimap. Oh, wait, there's one. Alright, let's get it fast. Oh my god, you really can use this underwater. Haha! Two question marks here. Nice. Check that one out. Who's here? Pirates. Do I still have my venom? 4 out of 20 on that. Let's go ahead and redo the venom. Yeah, and let's do Poison and Dragon's Dream again, because that was incredibly effective.
Don't let him catch his breath!
Ooh, wait a minute. I see an explosive barrel there. Let's do Dragon's Dream plus explosive barrel plus Igni.
Fucking bastard!
Alright, let's get them all in here. Oh, oh shit. Run!
Conjure it! Bastards, conjure it!
Alright, hold on.
Blowing goat, fucker!
Oh no, the cloud went away! Fuck! Alright, let's just do this. Alright, that did something. That did a lot of something.
In your guts, out, eh?
Didn't exactly want to throw it against the wall, but whatever.
Shit!
Guy walked into the poison and then died.
We'll flail your skin off. Go before son's eyes!
I forgot how good this weapon is. Why does it make no sound? Why does it keep making no sound? This weapon is so good. This weapon is insanely good. Like, my enemies, if I'm attacking them, they're just stunned all the time. Yeah, look at that! Like, one hit and they're stunned! Let's keep testing this.
Kill him, strip him, then dump him in a ditch!
Yeah! I swear this weapon stuns every single hit. But it's only got a 12% chance to stun and a 2% chance to freeze. But I swear it stuns every hit! Griffin Steel Sword Enhanced. Hmm. That's gotta be a really high level sword. Character? What? Quest? Inventory? Where's crafting recipes? Alchemy? Hmm. I guess I'm blind. It's a level 18. Looks like there's another question mark right next to here. With some other red things. Oh, more of them. Hey. I'm out of both of these, aren't I? Yep.
Right in numbers to work!
Okay, it doesn't stun every time. It didn't stun that time for one of them. But I swear it's more than like 12 or 14%. Just punch him. You want a fist fight? Fine. Oh, you got a sword. So much for that. What? That guy had jet propulsion. Where did his body go? Is it up in the tree? Seriously, where did his body go? Is that- that's his body! Oh my god! I decapitated him, and his body flew all the way from here. All the way from here. Wow. Spike Rogue Ackerton. What the heck is that? Let's see. It is terrible. It's really, really bad. What does it look like? Oh my god. Okay, it might be terrible, but it's actually really pretty. Huh, I'd like to keep it just for swag, but it is pretty heavy. Weighs 1.82. Ah, well. Was that it for the question marks? Ah, there's one here. Let's go get this question mark and then call it a day. Stuff in here. Probably not better than what I have, but still not bad. Lots of crafting ingredients. And if I didn't have saddlebags and horse blinders, that would have been super nice. Wow, these things really don't weigh much. Wow, even the barrels really don't weigh much. Go ahead and rest to get our stuff back. Okay, I think that's a pretty good place to end the episode. So, I hope you've enjoyed so far, and when I return, I think I'm gonna continue making my way down here. Yeah, I'm just gonna start hitting up all these question marks, start making my way down here, and finally end up with where I need to meet Kira Metz. Which would happen to be this one. Yeah, so there she is. The chance of me actually getting to do the main quest in the next episode is pretty low, because that's a lot of question marks along the way. So, hope you've enjoyed so far, and I'll be back soon.